This video is on the topic of reversible reactions. Many reactions go to completion, which means that when one of the reactants is used up, the reaction will stop. In this example of a complete reaction, the reaction stops when either the hydrochloric acid or the sodium hydroxide is used up. Some reactions behave differently. Take the reaction between hydrogen and nitrogen as an example. In this reaction, nitrogen and hydrogen react to produce ammonia. However, some ammonia can reform hydrogen and nitrogen, so both the forward reaction and the reverse reaction can occur. This is known as a reversible reaction. We show reversible reactions with the reversible symbol, which is drawn by two arrows, each with half an arrowhead, the top one pointing to the right and the bottom pointing to the left, to show that the reaction can go in both directions. We can represent a reversible reaction with this general equation, which shows the forward reaction where A and B can react to form C and D, and the reverse reaction where C and D react to form A and B. Note that sometimes the reverse reaction is also known as the backward reaction. Hydrated salts contain water within their lattice structure. This water is known as water of crystallization. Hydrated copper II sulfate is a blue solid that contains one formula unit of copper sulfate for every 5 molecules of water that is contained within its structure. The formula of hydrated copper II sulfate is shown by a dot between the salt and the 5 water molecules. When hydrated salts like copper II sulfate are heated, the hydrated salt loses its water, so is dehydrated and produces the anhydrous salt and water. Anhydrous copper II sulfate is a white solid, so you would see a colour change as it is heated. This reaction is an example of a reversible reaction, as the reaction can be reversed by adding water to the white anhydrous copper sulfate to produce the blue hydrated copper sulfate. The word and symbol equations are shown here. Remember to include the reversible symbol to show that it is a reversible reaction. As the forward reaction takes energy in, it is an endothermic reaction. When water is added to the anhydrous salt, heat energy is released, so the reverse reaction is exothermic. The same amount of energy that is taken in during the forward reaction will be released during the reverse reaction. Cobalt II chloride is another hydrated salt that can be heated to produce anhydrous cobalt II chloride and water. Hydrated cobalt II chloride is a pink solid, whereas anhydrous cobalt II chloride is blue, so a distinctive colour change is observed during this reaction. When water is added to blue anhydrous cobalt II chloride, the reverse reaction occurs and hydrated cobalt II chloride is formed, which is pink. The equations for this reaction are shown here. As with the previous example, the forward reaction is endothermic as energy is taken into the reaction, and the reverse reaction is exothermic as energy is released during the reaction. Remember that the same amount of energy that is taken in during the forward reaction will be released during the reverse reaction. Exam questions may focus on the observations made during this reaction. Examiners are expecting you to refer to the colour changes associated with the reaction. In questions that ask for observations, many students incorrectly state what is produced instead of saying what they would see. Here is an example of a typical exam question involving reversible reactions. It contains a reversible reaction that you will not have studied between copper ions and chloride ions, but you have the knowledge to be able to answer it, so never be put off by unfamiliar reactions. The first part of the question asking you what the symbol stands for is very common and should be an easy mark to pick up. You should state that the reaction is reversible. As the word is underlined in the mark scheme, it means that you need to use this word, or you can give the alternative answer that the reaction goes both ways. The next part of the question uses the suggest command word, which means you won't have specifically learnt why the reaction mixture may turn green, but you need to apply your knowledge of reversible reactions to be able to explain it. As it is a reversible reaction, both the forward reaction and reverse reaction occur, meaning that in the reaction mixture, all 3 ions given the equation will be present. As the copper 2 plus ion is blue and the copper compound is yellow, the reaction mixture will be a mixture of these 2 colours and appear green. Note the use of the word and in the mark scheme. This means you must specify both of these points to gain the mark. In summary, many reactions are complete reactions, but some reactions are reversible, as both the forward and the reverse reaction can occur. Reversible reactions are shown in equations by the use of the reversible symbol. The direction of a reversible reaction can be changed by changing the conditions. A common example of this is when hydrated salts are heated, the forward reaction occurs and the anhydrous salts and water are formed. This can be reversed by adding water. If a reversible reaction is exothermic in one direction, it will be endothermic in the other direction, and the amount of energy transferred will be the same in either direction. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.